Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause to Duya Meno. Scintillating performance, well done, well done, well done. Back to the business of the day, boxing. Now this next bout is an international light heavyweight challenge contest. It's time to bring the boxers out and to make their ring walks. First off, fighting all the way from Ghana, make welcome Joseph Tete.
This bout is for 8 rounds.
Seconds out. Run more.
And so we go in this exciting bout number eight right here at the King of the Ring Season 2, brought to you by Monarch Events and Promotions in conjunction with the Nigeria Boxing Board of Control. It is an international super middleweight contest, and it's an international light heavyweight contest between Victor Bennett of Ghana, Nigeria, and Joseph Tete of Ghana. Victor sporting the white trunks, fighting out of the red corner, and Joseph fighting out of the blue corner with a blue trunk and trimmings of white right there. And straight off, Bennett is going straight for the jugular, straight from the first round of this one. Eight-round contest we have right here. Both boxers still trying to size each other out right here. And Tete trying to gauge the strength and the skill of his opposition. Bennett, a younger one, 19 years of age, has a lot of prospect, has decided to go pro quite early in his career.
Looking quite big for his age, if you ask me. The Nigerian Victor Bennett, the man on the white trunk. Well, I think he chose the sport that really suits his physique. He chose that really fits how he looks. But it's not just about your physique, it's about your technique and how much you can execute your punches and how you can land your punch for the judges to score for you.
And yeah, you're right about that. But then both boxers still sizing each other out. Interestingly, it does look like Joseph Tete did not, turn pro early enough. He's at the age of 45 and has not been doing quite a lot.
Another Nigeria and Ghana rivalry. Another contest for sports. Another Jollof war. Another contest between Nigeria and Ghana when it comes to rivalry in sports. Joseph Tete and Victor Bennett in this King of the Ring boxing event right at Echo Club in Lagos. And that will do it for the first round. Not so much. Can't separate both boxers. Still process of sizing themselves up.
We are up to the second round of this bout number eight of the 10 bout fight night. King of the Ring Season 2, brought to you by Monarch Events and Promotions in collaborations with the Nigeria Boxing Board of Control, NBB of C, here at the Sports Hall of the Echo Club in Surulere, Lagos. It's experience up against youthfulness right here. The man in the white trunks, 19 years old. Nigeria's Victor Bennett up against the man from the blue corner, sporting blue trunks with white trimmings. And that's talking about Joseph Tete, who's 45 years of age. So quite a lot of age difference between these two boxers. There's a lot of youthfulness and energy coming out of Victor Bennett. But then, of course, Victor Tete, a properly conditioned fighter himself, you know, trying to match the energy that is expected from his younger, much younger opponent.
Well, Victor looks like a very conditioned boxer. Like Riley pointed out, he looks like a boxer that's regimented, like a soldier that is under order, that takes his punches when, you know, he's been commanded to. But sometimes you need to take risks. You need to fight out of the box. But he looks like he's just programmed to fight in a specific pattern.
Interestingly, both boxers are unbeaten. Victor Bennett has one professional fight, has two professional fights rather, and he has one win and a draw. And for his opponent, Joseph Tete, Tete has three professional fights, which is a bit surprising for a 45-year-old fighter. We just translate to the fact that he stayed in the amateur ranks for a longer time than I would say necessary, because at 45, he should be at that time, you know, calling time on his career. But then, of course, he's here in Nigeria, and it's another jollof battle between Nigeria and Ghana. And let's see who comes out tops in this one. Both boxers still interesting.
We've seen one jollof battle already, and that one, it turned out to be a Nigerian, was far sweeter.
Better than Ghana.
So this time around, I think the Ghanaians will want to say something about this one in terms of coming out terms. But of course, Victor Bennett seems to be very ready for whatever Joseph Tete has to throw at him.
And so we wait and expect that these two boxers will come out from their corners. But so far, so good. So much of, not taking risk. Both boxers trying to be too cautious. They have seen that both of them have what it takes to take the other out. So they're trying to measure their punches and not wanting to, you know, just lunge forward and get caught in the process. It's round three coming up in about a matter of seconds. Stay right there. Don't go anywhere, especially those of you are catching this action live online on Fight TV.
Seconds out, round three.
So they're off and running for the third round. It's Ghana against Nigeria. Joseph Tete in the blue trunks, the man from Ghana, while Victor Bennett, the Nigerian, in the white trunk. It's been keenly contested. The balance in terms of height, no much advantage in terms of who has a longer reach. Fighting a very regimented style, both boxers. But sometime later in this match, somebody needs to take a risk. Somebody needs to try to outsmart the other. Victor Bennett now trying to step up the game, try to take the fight to Joseph Tete of Ghana. Joseph Tete fighting back with some quick combination. Left hook, Victor Bennett. Still king of the rings. Boxing. Second edition right here in Lagos. Left jab that time from Victor Bennett. It's now coming to a crunch time. Victor Bennett, great combination. Looking good now for the Nigerian. With a left hook. He has the stance of a southpaw, Nero.
Yeah, he does have a stance of a southpaw, but he is actually an orthodox boxer. But he's able to mix both of them, and his hands are very strong. But you often seen that, oftentimes see that he uses his right jabs a lot more rather than the left jab. And I must say, brilliant showing from him. But he needs to. It's gone in again, and he's got the reach as well. But he needs to be a lot more consistent. He's giving too much respect to Victor Tete, Joseph Tete. And it's understandable because of course, the experience of Joseph Tete in boxing generally, but not necessarily in terms of professional boxing.
I think another thing of the only thing I'd see Victor Bennett lacking is a footwork. He seems to just want to pin. Oh, but he's coming in now with some left jabs. His left hand looks very dangerous, but I don't know why he's just pinning. He doesn't want to be on his toes. He's just walking in, but his movement is just slowly, gradually, but not flexible in terms of footwork. I don't know, maybe that should be his own style.
Well, I think he's flexible. I saw Victor in one of his other fights, and I think he was quite flexible. I think it depends on the opposition that Victor gets. And in this case, he hasn't seen any reason why he should be so, very dynamic with his footwork. He plants himself on the ground.
Yeah, it looks like he's just planting himself.
And he's looking for that. The more you plant yourself on the ground, the stronger your punches are. And that's exactly what he's looking for. He has found out that he has an opponent who is durable, who is capable of taking some of these punches, but he needs to land those big punches, and he needs to land them consistently to be able to scare Joseph Tete.
That was out, round four.
And Joseph Tete himself is a very experienced boxer. We've seen it. I'm not sure whether he has the killer punches that can actually worry Victor Bennett, but so far so good. We'll wait and see whether we can see some sort of stoppage in this one.
Well, nobody has the advantage when it comes to height. I mean, their reach seems to almost be balanced in terms of what they can throw in. Victor Bennett now gradually coming into this game, gradually picking the right time to land his punches. And quite a unique style, Victor.
And I hope it's not so much of overconfidence coming from Victor. He's known now that he can hurt Joseph Tete when he wants to. But I expect to see a lot more of that left jab to really get a lot of the points in. It's going to be a so far so good. It's a low. Oh, yeah, there you have it. All he needs to do is walk in there and try and throw those combinations in there. But he needs to use those jabs to set it up, because like I said, that's it.
Yeah.
The more he does that, the more he's going to keep Joseph Tete at bay. And another nice jab that really feels like more like a serious jab there.
I think it was underestimating Victor by trying to say he doesn't just move in terms of his footwork. But I think he's just beating his time. I think he's just gradually getting to this match. He's setting him up with the left jabs and follow up with the right hooks. Great body shot that time from Victor. Oh, straight jab, straight to the face. I think that he's caught all of that one. Well executed, perfectly executed that time. What a very unique style. It seems to be planting his foot right on the canvas, but doesn't stop him from moving when he needs to move.
Absolutely. He's standing
still. He's not just bouncing around, but he's moving when he needs to move.
Yeah, so that's why I said it depends on his opposition. If he gets the opposition that is very mobile, he would have to move as mobile as that as well. But he's fighting a man who both of them literally almost have the same kind of stance, and he's advancing the way he wants to advance forward. But I only wish that he could do more. But I'm also a bit disappointed in the more experienced Joseph Tete. I expect to see a lot more. But he's rather more like waiting to defend counter rather than taking the fight to the younger Victor Bennett, who obviously does not have the same kind of experience that he has.
Well, Joseph Tete, like you rightly pointed out, seems to just want to wait and allow Victor Bennett to, you know, just push him all the way backwards. He's still King of the Ring, second edition, right here in the city of Lagos, Echo Club. Great match in Nigeria and Ghana. Victor Bennett, Nigeria, in the red corner, in the white trunk. And of course, Joseph Tete in the blue corner from Ghana. Of course, it's another Jollof War. And it's round five coming up. Where will this one swing? Heavyweight category, this one. An international light heavyweight fight.
Round five
in the offing.
Yes, Victor Bennett, Nigeria's Victor Bennett, in the white trunks, up against his opponent from Ghana. Another Jollof War right here in the King of the Ring Season 2, brought to you by Monarch Events and Promotions in conjunction with the Nigeria Boxing Board of Control, NBB of C. It's taking place at the Sports Hall of the Echo Club in Surulere, Lagos, Nigeria. And really, really good showing from the Nigerians so far in this bout. And we're going all the way to 8 rounds before the last two bouts come your way. Of course, still looking forward to the main event of the night. Tasif Khan, the English and Pakistani-English boxer, who will be taking on Gabriel Larrie, who is from Ghana, for the WBO, that's World Boxing Organization Africa Super Flyweight title. And it promises to be an exciting one. But before then, we also have an international contest. It is a super middleweight contest. Ezra Erenyeka up against Frank Dodzi of Ghana. Another international and another Jollof War we have there. Nice body punches coming from Joseph Tete, who got caught there. And you can see Joseph Tete himself coming up with some good combinations. But beautiful jab coming from Victor Bennett. Who's proving that he can actually receive as much as he can dish out as well. Tete rides that. Both boxers still quite calculating and a bit cautious. We're waiting. We want them to throw caution to the wind and let's have a proper rumble right here in Lagos.
I think Victor has all the ingredients that makes a great boxer. Though I'm looking at this man. He can be flexible if he wants to. He can be a power puncher if he wants to. He can be a calculative boxer also if he wants to. I think he just has all the right combination, all the right skills that produces a great boxer. He just needs to do more in terms of execution and he needs to be more consistent. He looks like a very disciplined boxer and can defend also when he needs to and can step aside when he needs to, but he needs to be more consistent and, you know, follow up his punches when he needs to. And I mean, he has a great future ahead of him with what I'm saying here.
I totally agree with you as well. 19 years of age, good body, a good build, and he's definitely showing that he can definitely box. And I'm sure we will be seeing a lot more from this young man who is still learning the ropes and still, you know, gathering a lot more experience. He's only got 2 fights, don't forget. And these 2 fights, 1 victory and 1 draw for him. And he's up also up against an experienced amateur boxer in none other than Joseph Tete, who's got three It's got three professional bouts, having won two out of those and drawn one.
Well, it's quite impressive for him to turn professional at the age of 19. Very few Nigerians could say they turned professional at that age. So great prospects and great future lies ahead of this man in the white trunk. Talking about Victor Bennett representing Nigeria in this King of the Ring boxing show put together by Monarch Promotions right here at the Echo City Club in the city of Lagos, Nigeria. And of course, on Fly TV. It's still Joseph Tete against Nigerian Victor Bennett in a keenly contested energy serpent fight. Eighth bout of the night in what has turned out to be a glorious night of boxing. And Victor Bennett following up with some left hook and jabs also. Body shots, quick punches, and he can mix it up also. Sometimes he looks like a southpaw, another time he looks like an orthodox boxer.
Yes, and a lot of Nigerian boxing fans want to see Victor, you know, let loose those jabs and, you know, throw them a lot more so that he can set up a good, powerful right hand. But he does that in flashes, and then after a while he goes back into his shell. It could be that he's trying to you know, conserve energy, but I must say that's a big one there, catching Tete, catches him on the ropes, and Tete dances out of it as well, and the fans clapping for this young man. Tete has given a good account of himself as well.
Well, I think that they're just holding out, possibly looking for the right opening to knock a sucker punch to Victor Bennett. But I don't think all round he has come to the party in terms of matching up Victor Bennett's skill for skill, quality for quality, in terms of how it has been from the first round up till now. Victor Bennett seemed to be the better boxer in terms of approach, in terms of style, in terms of execution of the punches. And yet again, you can see him throwing the left hook. Oh, left jab that time. You see, this man has all the qualities that can make a great boxer. He's mean, he's fierce. For a young man, I think he's done pretty well for himself. For a young, at that age, for him to have this composure, confidence, and so much power at that age, I think he has great future ahead of him.
I totally agree with you. I thought he was going to lose his cool being a youngster after that, after Joseph Tete tried to, you know, connect with the punch after the bell. But you saw he was a bit angry at the end of the day. But when Joseph Tete stretched his hands out for, you know, for a touch of gloves, he touched him and still went off, even still with a mean face, you know, like that wasn't funny, but it's okay. But and that's exactly what you need to be. You need to be calm. You need to be in control of yourself so that you do not lose your composure.
Circles out, round seven.
Round seven on the way already in this international light heavyweight contest. Victor Bennett of Nigeria in the white trunks up against Joseph Tete of Ghana. Another Jollof war right here. Thank you.
I think Joseph Tete has been too defensive for my liking, for his height and for the fact that he's been in professional boxing for some time now. I think he could have done better in terms of being on the offensive. But probably he's met a boxer that wants to keep him at bay. And probably if he had fought a boxer that could let him walk in dead, it could have been much more easier for Joseph Tete of Ghana. But Victor Bennett not giving him any kind of respite at all in this particular fight.
Yeah, Joseph Tete has a chance, or has the ability to make this fight a bit more exciting than it is. But he's just too cautious in his approach to things. Doesn't want to get hit. But the bottom line is, from the way things are going, he's obviously trailing. From our own, you know, assessment of the fight, he should be trailing on the scorecard of the...
Oh!
I think that's a sleep. And I... that's definitely a sleep there. It's no knockdown. I think Victor Bennett inadvertently stepped on the shoes, on the trainers of Joseph Tete. And while Tete was trying to backtrack, you know, his legs were pinned to the canvas and he couldn't move.
Exactly what has been his problem all throughout this fight. Always backtracking, always stepping backwards. Sometimes you need to take the risk, be on the offensive, and stick the man in front and just meet him in his face. Take the fight to him. I mean, he's just been defending so too much. And yet again, backtracking. Yet again, not doing so much in terms of attacking. So you could stumble if you keep defending.
And you're not going to win fights by, you know, not throwing punches. You need to throw the punches. And Tete has made this fight a bit boring. And you see him, even when he has his man on the corner, he's even not throwing the punches. He's looking for openings. You're not going to find the openings. What you need to do is the punches should give you the opening. You can see that. And you see that lovely counter coming from Victor Bennett there. Victor was expecting a lot more barrage of punches. He didn't get any. And after a while, he had to come out of the corner and attack. But unfortunately for him, the bell went for that one. And we're getting closer and closer to the end of this one. In fact, we're up for the eighth and the final round in this international light heavyweight contest between Nigeria's Victor Bennett and his Ghanaian opponent, Joseph Tete.
Seconds out, run, it's the final round.
Eighth and final round in this international bout between Nigeria and Ghana. Of course, Victor Bennett and Joseph Tete of Ghana. Body shot that time now from Victor Bennett. Did they save the best for last? Let's see in this particular round, Victor Bennett. His poise is just amazing. He doesn't just stay on his toes, but his stance very, very... Oh, great combination that I'm looking for some body shots. Quite remarkable stance from Victor Bennett, giving no chance for Joseph Tete to be on the offensive at all. Almost throughout this fight. I mean, you cannot be on the defensive right from round one to round eight and you expect to walk away with the victory.
Absolutely not. You can be on defensive, but you should be throwing punches as well. It's called defensive boxing. There is an art that the likes of Floyd Mayweather would put up. You know, they are on the defensive all the time, but there are times when they launch forward and throw combinations, and we have seen nothing of that sort coming from Joseph Tete. So it does make it feel like, I don't know if his corner is doing anything about this or he himself is hoping to do something, because in his heart of hearts, he knows that he hasn't thrown as many punches as Victor Bennett and he hasn't scored as many points as Victor Bennett. So he should be looking to win this fight. And this is going for broke, but he's not ready to do anything about this.
Well, time taken away for Joseph Tete, the man from Ghana in the blue trunks, no doubt about this, he's trailing Victor Bennett by large margins, if you ask me. Looks like Victor Bennett's just going to walk away with this one. It looks like a stroll in the park, definitely, for Victor Bennett. There's no chance in the world that this man have any chance, unless he comes up with something remarkable in the dying seconds of this final eighth round.
And it's obvious that Victor really wants to fight, but Tete catches him there. But now we expect to see a lot more of that. Like I said, Tete oftentimes waits for him to get hit first before he tries to make, a counter. But he needs to try to take the initiative and try to be the one to put in the punches rather than just waiting to get punched first before he replies.
And gradually winding down the end of this fight, looking like Victor Bennett has this one wrapped up. I really want to see this man how far he can go in his career, because he has everything that makes a great boxer. Stance, movement, he has the punches, he's flexible and still has great punches. And that will be that in this international bout. Victor Bennett wanted more. You could see he felt he could have done much more. I'm very sure his one is on point, but he's still hungry for more. He's still not satisfied with his performance, but I think it's good enough in terms of scoring points. And what a fighter.
Absolutely, what a fighter. He's a guy who loves to fight, and you can see it in his face. The wings on his face shows you that he definitely wanted to get something out of this, but his opponent was like pretty much like looking like he wasn't up for, a real battle here. And as such, we would have to go for decisions rather than, looking for a stoppage in this one, because all the eight rounds are now officially exhausted. And we go to the rings, to the ring once again, where the ring announcer, talking about Ralph Chidozie George, is right there. And I always love this young man for this. He always does this every time. He sees a boxing as a passion. And he always goes over to his opponent to greet them. And you'll see the way things are going. And we dare say that this man has a big future in Nigerian boxing and international boxing as well. All he needs is formidable promoters to put him out there, give him the platform to showcase his talent, and of course to get more training from quality trainers as well. Okay, we'll go straight to the ring right now, where Ralph Chidozie George is waiting with referee Segun Adesanya for the official decision.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. The fighters once again left it in the hands of the judges, and the judges have scored it. After 8 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecard. George Constance Chiagoro scores his 73-79. George G. George scores his 79-73. George Tayo Olaipa scores it 87-82 for the winner.